Hello friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So let's begin today's video of current affairs that is going to cover the questions that are provided in your March 1st daily current affairs document. So guys, the very first question that we have in front of us is, what is the venue of 2022 MSME conclave for National SC/ST Hub? So here option B, Sindhu Durg, which is in Maharashtra, is the right answer. And guys, nothing major has happened during this conclave. It is just that the conclave was organized in this region, and during the conclave, Union Bank MSME Rupee Credit Card was launched, and Coir Ward Regional Office was inaugurated at Khankavali in Sindhu Durg. So these are two important developments that happened during this meeting. And the important part here is that the KVIC chairperson was also present. So you need to know the name of the person, that is Vinay Kumar Saxena. Moving ahead to the next question. Which of the following animal is symbolically portrayed in the special logo which was released to commemorate the 75 years of diplomatic relations between India and Belgium? So guys, Belgium is one of the first European countries that engaged in the diplomatic relations when India became independent in 1947. So here guys, the right answer is peacock. Now let me show you the logo. So the logo is like this, okay? Next question is, which of the following operations has been launched by India to airlift Indian nationals from Ukraine? So I hope that you all have come across this news that India is airlifting its nationals from Ukraine, from the bordering nations like Hungary, Romania, Poland, Slovakia. So from all these nations, particularly from Budapest in Hungary and Bucharest in Romania, these operations are going on. So the operation is Operation Ganga. Apart from this, recently Prime Minister Narendra Modi has also conducted a high-level meeting to discuss the impact of sanctions imposed on Russia on the Indian economy. Now, you would be amazed that what kind of impact would India suffer with the sanctions on Russia. So guys, remember that S-400 defense deal is there with India. Okay, with the sanctions, especially the swift ban on Russia now, it would be next to impossible for India to procure that system. Plus, we also export a good amount of tea to Ukraine and Russia. So that export is also going to be affected. Third development related to the Russia-Ukraine crisis is that India is planning to send its four ministers, Jyotiraditya Sindhia, your VK Singh, your Kiran Rijuju, and Hardeep Singh Puri. All these four ministers are going to visit the bordering nations of Ukraine and aid in the Operation Ganga. However, their presence in the border nations would be symbolic, just to give encouragement to the Indian nationals who are stranded there. Okay, so these are the recent developments related to Russia and Ukraine, and what is the background of the war that I have discussed in the yesterday's video. Moving ahead to the next question. With which country has India agreed to form a joint hydro development committee to further explore the development of viable hydropower projects in that nation? So here, Nepal, guys, is the right answer. Remember that Nepal aspires to become the powerhouse of Asia. Now, you need to know that Nepal has abundance of water resources, and if all the resources are put to optimal use, then Nepal can definitely fulfill its aspirations to become the powerhouse of Asia. Okay, and recently it has generated surplus electricity also through hydropower, and thus it was a historic achievement on the part of Nepal. Okay. Okay, so here we have the next question. When was the Bhasha Sangam mobile application launched? So guys, it was launched last year. I hope that you have covered this in Spotlight and Daily Current Affairs videos as well. So now, why are we discussing this question again? First of all, know the answer, then I will tell you why am I discussing this application again. So it is October 31st, 2021, the birth anniversary of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, the Iron Man of India. Now, why are we discussing this? Because Ministry of Education has recently launched this Bhasha Certificate Selfie campaign. What is it? It is nothing but a campaign to encourage the young people to learn more and more Indian languages. Okay, more and more does not mean that one individual is being encouraged to learn all the Indian languages. No, 22 Indian official languages are there, and the target of this initiative, Bhasha Mobile Sangam application or the Bhasha Sangam initiative, is to have 75 young people to encourage them to learn Indian languages, thus to promote Indian languages, and at the same time Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat campaign will also be promoted. Okay, so that is the entire idea of Bhasha Sangam initiative, and for that initiative the application was launched on October 31st by Ministry of Education and My Government India. Okay, so this is showing you how you can learn the language better by learning 100 plus sentences of daily use in 22 scheduled languages of India. Okay, now guys, here again, not 75 people, actually there are 75 lakh people, which is the target. Okay, so I'm again correcting myself, it is these 75 lakh people, the target of Bhasha Sangam initiative. Okay, now guys, another point here is that October 31 is also celebrated as Rashtriya Ekta Divas in India. Which country was the partner country in the DSTCII Technology Summit 2022? So here guys, Singapore is the right answer. So 28th edition of this summit was recently conducted on the theme of building economies for the future. Now apart from this, what are the major points that you can grasp from the exam point of view? First is that Singapore was the partner country, which is evident from the name itself. But if the question is framed in this manner, then you would definitely get confused about the partner country. So it is Singapore, do remember. Next, Vipin Sondhi is the chairman of this summit. Now guys, wait, there is more to this news. First is that Singapore has announced to set up its Global Alliance, Innovation Alliance centers in more Indian cities. One center is already there in Bangalore, and Singapore aims to expand the network of these centers in different cities. But the question that can be framed out of this sentence is the city where already a center has been established by Singapore, that is Bangalore. An MOU was also signed between India and Singapore for cooperation in science, technology and innovation field. Moving ahead, where does the breed of Mudhol hounds found in abundance in India? So here guys, option D is the right answer. These kinds of hounds are found on the borders of Maharashtra and Karnataka. But why are we talking about these hounds? The reason is that 10 months ago, In the Man Ki Baat discussion, Prime Minister Narendra Modi himself hinged on using the indigenous breeds of dogs in police squads. Okay, in light of that statement that he made 10 months back, this is in the news that now the police is searching for indigenous breeds of dogs that can be included in the police. Okay. So that is why this kind of hounds are in the news. And do remember that this breed specifically was hinted at by Prime Minister Narendra Modi during his discussion in Man Ki Baat also. Okay. Next question. When was Ramalinga Swami re-entry fellowship launched? So here FY07, that is 2006 to 2007 is the right answer. Now guys, there are some schemes which have their launch years written like these, because sometimes it happens that the scheme was announced in the previous year and it was launched in the later part of one financial year. For example, if let's suppose, okay, I'm not telling you the exact months of the scheme. For example, in August 2006, this scheme was announced, and in January 2007, this scheme was launched. So will you say that this scheme was launched in two separate years? No, the financial year is same, that is FY07. Now let's move into the details of this scheme. Now guys, why is it in the news? First of all, this should be your question. So here, the reason behind this scheme in the news is that 36th Foundation Day of Department of Biotechnology was celebrated And on this occasion, the Ministry of Science and the Minister of Science and Technology has informed that over 550 Indian biotechnologists have returned to India under this scheme. That is why this scheme is in the news. Now, what is the purpose of this scheme? So basically, this scheme was launched by the Department of Biotechnology in order to bring back the scientists who are working abroad in order to curb the brain drain from India. So that is the basic purpose. Moving ahead, recently, central government has announced that no funds will be provided to states which do not appoint ombudspersons in -% of their districts where the scheme is implemented. So here, guys, 80% is the right answer. You should be aware of this fact that MG Narega is one scheme that is facing a shortage of funds in many states. Thus, the workers are not able to get their wages on time. Thus, the government has announced, or rather made it mandatory for the states to appoint an ombudsperson for this scheme particularly. Now, if a state wants to avail the funds from the center, then in majority of the districts where the scheme of MG Narega is implemented at present, there should be an ombudsperson, okay, appointed by the states. That is the current news and update on MG Narega. Moving ahead, which state has the highest installed renewable energy capacity in India? So guys, this is one of the favorite questions of the day for me. Okay, so let's know what is the right answer here. It is Tamil Nadu. Why did I say that it is one of my favorite questions from the session? Because guys, this is stating you how much have we achieved in the renewable energy. Okay, our target is to have 175 gigawatts of renewable energy by 2022. Now, you will also come across certain news headlines that would state that India's target is to achieve 175 gigawatt by 2023. So, which one is the right answer? The right answer is this. By financial year FY23, the government aims to achieve the 175 gigawatt of renewable energy target and the doubling of farmers' income. Okay, I hope that this is visible. Farmers' income. Okay, I hope that you can understand. So these two targets are for the 22 year. So here we have Tamil Nadu being ranked at the first position in terms of the overall renewable energy capacity that is installed, that is operational at present. So we have 15,914 megawatts in Karnataka, in Tamil Nadu. The second state is Karnataka with 15,795 megawatts. Now, there is a very mild difference between these states. Why did I say Karnataka? Because Tamil Nadu has snatched this position from Karnataka in the last year's ranking, the previous rankings. Karnataka was at the first position in terms of installed renewable energy capacity. Now comes Gujarat, which is at the third number. Okay, with 15,518 megawatt of capacity. Now, guys, if particularly we talk about the solar, rooftop solar installations, then Gujarat is number one in India. Okay, so out of the total 6,405 megawatt of rooftop capacity, Gujarat has 1,679 megawatt of capacity. This is important. Okay. Next is that world's largest renewable energy park, that is hybrid renewable energy park, wind plus solar, okay, is also being developed in Kutch, Gujarat. So this, guys, is an old news. We have discussed it n number of times. Sorry. Last is Rajasthan. So Rajasthan's overall renewable energy capacity is 14,983 megawatts. And if we talk about the solar capacity, the total solar capacity, then Rajasthan stands at the first position in India with 10,507 megawatt of installed solar capacity. We are not talking about rooftop solar capacity. We are talking about the overall solar capacity. Okay, there is a difference between the rooftop and the overall solar power capacity. That may include your floating solar power plants also. Next question is, which of the following is not a habitat of dugong? Guys, this dugong is a mammal. Okay, mammal of the sea. Okay, Now it is only found at four locations. Okay. So Palk Bay, Gulf of Mannar, which are in Tamil Nadu, Gulf of Kutch, which is in Gujarat, and Andaman and Nicobar Island. So clearly the right answer here is Lakshadweep Island. Why is it in the news again? So again, it is an old news, okay, that Tamil Nadu has announced to start, Tamil Nadu had already announced to develop India's first dugong conservation reserve in the Palk Bay region. And right now, at the present moment, Tamil Nadu has started work on building the conservation reserve. Now, dugongs are endangered species under the Schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. Moving ahead, what is the target of wheat procurement by Government of India in the upcoming Rabi marketing season? So here guys, 44.4 million tons is the right answer. So here you can see the state-wise procurement of wheat is also mentioned. Like from Punjab, 13.2 million tons will be procured, from Madhya Pradesh this much, and so on. Last year, the government procured this much, 43.34 million tons on MSP. So guys, this is about wheat. Now let's have a look at rice procurement also, which is decided at 4.29 million tons of rice. Next is, where is the headquarters of International Judo Federation located? It is in Budapest. Why is it in the news? Because it has suspended Vladimir Putin, okay, as its president. So Vladimir Putin was the honorary president of International Judo Federation, and now in the wake of his invasion in Ukraine, he has been suspended. Which of the following has become the first multilateral agency to open an office in the Gujarat International FinTech Finance Tech City, that is FinTech City? It is, guys, New Development Bank, which was initially started by the BRICS nations in Shanghai. Do remember, its headquarters is in Shanghai. Recently, three countries have joined the New Development Bank in order to expand the scope of the bank. Tell me the name of the three countries that have become the newest members of this BRICS bank, we can say. Okay. Next question is, where is India's first smart managed EV charging station located? So guys, it is located in Delhi. Next question is, which is the solar power park developer for all renewable energy projects in Himachal Pradesh? So it is Satluj Jal Vidyut Nigam. Now what is the recent news? The recent news is that Ministry of New and Renewable Energy has approved the development of 400 megawatt of solar park by Satluj Jal Vidyut Nigam in Kinnaur in Himachal Pradesh. So this is, guys, the present news, because of which it is in the news. The SJVN is in the news. Now do remember that the same company is also developing this Kaza Solar Park in Himachal Pradesh. Moving ahead, who is the chairperson of SEBI? New person has been appointed. It is Madhavi Puri Butch. Guys, we have discussed recent committee of which she was made the chairperson. Which is that committee? And that question was in your SEBI examination also. Tell me the committee of which she is the present chairperson along with SEBI now. When is the Polio National Immunization Day observed? So guys, here February 27 is the right answer. Okay, February 27. Recently, Polio National Immunization Drive has also been launched in order to immunize the children. Okay. Guys, do remember, universal immunization is done under Mission Indradhanush. Okay. Which team has won the Pro Kabaddi League 2021? So here, Dabang Delhi is the right answer. And which team has won the Rupee Prime Volleyball League 2022? So Kolkata Thunderbolts. Here is the right answer. So guys, here the session ends. I hope that you have enjoyed the session, and do not feel at any point of time that something is missing in the session or something is deliberately left out of the session. No guys, it is not so. Everything that needs attention has been discussed in detail. Still, if you have any kind of doubt regarding any news, you can mention in the live chat or in the comments also. I'm watching the session with you. You can discuss with me anything at any point of time if you don't understand that. Okay, so here guys, if you like the session, then do not forget to subscribe the channel, hit the bell notification, and also share this video among your friends. Thank you.